pleasure to welcome you to this evening's talk by Dr. Nagasamy. We are very fortunate that he is able to come from time to time and deliver some lectures under the banner of Madhuradhwani. And I only made him to use his banner also, Tamil Arts Academy. It's very nice of him to agree to that. So this topic again is a great interest to all of us, the origin of music and dance. I have nothing more to add, sir, the floor is yours. Papu Venugopal Rao, at my request and doctor's suggestion, he has come here. Very thankful to you, sir. I know you stay very far. We won't hold you more than 7:45. We will leave you before that. Thank you.
Friends, and Mr. Venugopal Rao, Valli, and all great people assembled here. I want to tell you first, I am neither a musician, nor a musicologist, nor I know anything about classical dance. But still, I am venturing to say something about this origin of dance and music. I want to apologize that I have not been able to transfer whatever I have done in my iPad, and I have thought of illustrating the talk with a number of sculptures also, so that I can connect it with it. But unfortunately, for the past 3 days, my internet connection is down, and I have not been able to even complete. So it is incomplete. My talk is in 3 parts. Number one, I am talking about the earliest ideas about music as a classical art preserved, understandable by us, without any doubt or arguments, how far we are able to go. That part is number one. The second part is we all speak of our music and also dance coming from Veda. We say this is from Veda. So I wanted to connect actually whether there is any connection between Veda and the later classical musical tradition. So mine is essentially historical analysis of evolution of earliest thought on music and how it evolved through the centuries. So kindly keep it in mind that I am not talking about the modern aspect. The third part deals with what I consider as very important for all artists to understand, that from very early times, every region has developed its own concept and style, which has been incorporated in his masterly treatise by Bharatamuni, Bharata. So even at the time of Bharata's Natyashastra, we see each region has its own contribution. And there has been great men who have codified in the regional languages, Prakrit language or Tamil language, in addition to Sanskrit. So these are the main 3 points that I am going to speak about. The first one is we have a few set of words that we use generally, like you call swara, and then you call udatta, anudatta, swarita, or you call it mantara, madhyama, and tara. And then you also speak of aksharas, and then you speak of matras. These are all fundamental words for both music and dance. And raga, bhava. So I thought I'll start with a small shantipata in the Veda and then come to the subject. And so let me see how we start with the shantipata.
Om Sanno Mitra Samvarunaha Channo Bhavatvaryama Channa Indro Bruhaspatihi Channo Vishnur Vurukramaha Namo Brahmane Namaste Vayo Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahma Vadishyami Ritam Vadishyami Satyam Vadishyami Tanmam avatu, tadvaktaram avatu, avatu mam, avatu vaktaram. Om Santi Santi Santi. Siksham yakhyasyamaha, varnasvaraha, matrabalam, samasantanaha, ityuktaha. Sikshadhyayaha.
Now we have two parts in this recitation. Number one is the Shantipata, and the other one is what is called Siksha. Or in Vedic terminology, it gets elongated as Siksha. And this occurs in Taittiriya Upanishad, and the student is first taught about this before he goes on to the other subjects. It deals with how one should pronounce ucharana of words, pada, and communicate the meaning. Now all that you say in modern terminology about this music and dance, they are all there in this Shantipata. It is the root, it is the base. This base, you develop the whole thing. Now let us see, when we say Om Sanno Mitrasam Varunaha, see, this is an address to Varuna, Mitra, and God Varuna, and then God Aryama, and then Brihaspati, and Urukrama Vishnu. Now, how is it connected with this Siksha? Now, Mitra is none other than Surya. And Surya is adored by everyone with Gayatri Mantra as Savita. So, this is connected with Gayatri. Gayatri is a sacred mantra, which is also a chandas in music. Gayatri, Anashtubhrati, all these are all also chandas in music. Even in Bharata's Natyashastra, you get these words. So, you have a mantra, you have also connection with music. So, we pray to this Mitra Varuna. Mitra, Varuna are all dual deities. I am not going into the details of it. Then you have Aryama, another name of Mitra. So these are the Vedic deities. We pray for their blessings. Then you have Brihaspati. Brihaspati is the giver of knowledge or the presiding deity of knowledge. He himself is knowledge. So Brihaspati is adored. Then Vishnu as Urukrama is Trivikrama. One of his leg is on the ground, earth, and the other earth leg is lifted up. He is measuring the space. And you are going to measure the space with all your music and dance. And it is what your kalpana is going to take you in measuring the whole thing. And so we adore Vishnu as Trivikrama to give us that faculty to measure the whole thing. Trivikrama, it's something very fantastic. Then we worship Namaste Vayu. Vayu. Vayu is important because you produce the sound from your body. You pump and articulate the sound which comes out as both mantra and also as music. So here we say you are the Pratyaksha Brahma. So far as this mantra is concerned, the music is concerned, and also that is translated into dance in bodily movement. So that is why Vayu is specially adored in this Santipada before Siksha is taken up. Then you get Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi. I am worshipping you as the very embodiment of the Supreme. Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahma Vadishyami. I say you are Brahma. Then you say, I am telling you eternal truth, not which is peripheral, passing, but it eternal truth. Vayu as prana. That is the most important thing so far as this human life is concerned. So Vayu is adored. Then it goes on to the Siksha. In the Vedic tradition, the first one is Siksha, pronunciation. So it is very important for mantra. It is very important for music. It is very important for all aspects. So they first start with the teacher tells the student how to pronounce. It cannot be reduced to writing. So it has to be transmitted only through oral tradition. It cannot be written down. So when we say Yezha Kilavi, that which cannot be written, it does not mean that the Vedic people do not know how to write or communicate. It means you cannot communicate it. It has to be learned only through traditional oral transmission. So Siksha Vyakhyasama. There are only six words in this Siksha. Varnaswaraha. Varnaswaraha. Matra balam. Samasantanaha. So you have six words. The first one is Varna. You know, you talk of Varna. Varna, Shankara says, Adi Shankara in his commentary says, Varna means Akara Adi Aksharas. Varna. Swara, Udata, Anudata, Swarita, which you also say in your music, up, middle, and down. Varna, Swara. Swara is also what you call Shajja, Rishabha, Madhyama, Gandhara, and so on. That's, it has two meanings. Swara. Then, matras. Matras are the measurement of the letters. One matra, two matras, you say. And then Guru Lagu. Same thing you say, Guru Lagu. So that is classified in the way that the earliest stage as matras. Then you have Balam. Balam is the strength. It depends upon your strength to pronounce and pump out your air, to articulate it, to bring it into various shapes. And so that is Balam. I think it is almost like Murchana, what you call. Then Sama is Shruti. What you see, you must have a balance. So Samattam, Sama, says Shankara. And then you have the last one is Santana. How you combine these aksharas into pada, and how padas are composed into words, and so on. So what happens is, in Santana, you also introduce what is called the bhava. The padas have to be in with bhavas also. So you have all that is required for matra, guru, lagu, akshara, swara, everything is first taught by the guru to the student. This is what is there in the Santipada. Now, there is one Samavedic Pandit whom I met, and I asked him, how do you say that this Samaveda gives rise to music? Then I asked him to demonstrate. I told him, give me a Rig. Rig is mantra. Rig is a hymn. It's just simply pronounced without any This is Rig. Now then, the Vedic scholars, they split it up into what they call Pada-Pada-Pata, Patya. They also call it Patya, Pada-Pata-Patya. Split the words. And then they say Gana, you sing it. So you have three stages with which you can understand how the ordinary Rig, the hymn which praises the beauty of nature, is reduced and divided into parts, and then how you introduce music, articulation and bhava and meaning. So I asked him to recite. It's a long one, but I have cut it down because I know we have to stop it in 1 hour. And so it will come to about 8 minutes or so. He gives the definition in Hindi, but you can easily follow it. I think there is no difficulty in following it up. Now, before that, there is a word, a sloka in your Sangeet Ratnakara by Sarangadeva. Why are you taking music first? Why not dance first? Then he says, see, Nrittam Vadyanugam. Nritta has to follow the Vadya, instrumental music. And Vadyam Geetanuvartini. Then Vadya, it follows. Ataha Geeta Pradhanatvate Atra Adav Gītam abhidhīyate. So it is Gita, first you say music and then you go on to that. Next one, sir. Now we have the Veda Pātha, which is, you can follow it. He speaks about Veda Mantra, Pāṭhya, and then the music, how it is sung in Samaveda. Next.
Ek Richāka कहीं कहीं तीन गान है वही एक ही ऋचा का लेकिन गान का फर्क बहुत पृथकता उसमें नजर आता है जैसा अग्न आया ही वीतये गृणानो हव्यदातये निहोता सत्से बड़ी हिशी ये पहला मंत्र है ये पहला मंत्र में तीन गान हैं एक हुआ ओग्नाई अग्न आया ही वी अग्न आया ही बाई तयाई ये अब वहाँ पर ऋचा में कहा गया है अग्न आया ही जब गान शुरू करते हैं उसमें कहते हैं ओग्नाई ये जो फर्क है अर्थात ऋचा के अनुसार जो गान है ऋच्छद्योरम सामगीयते जो कहते हैं इसमें अंतर आ रहा है क्यों इसके लिए प्रातिशाख्य प्रमाण है प्रातिशाख्य में कहाँ कहाँ पर कौन आगम होगा कौन लोप होगा कौन आरोप होगा कहाँ विराम होगा कहाँ ये होगा इसके संबंध में लक्षण ग्रंथ जो प्रातिशाख्य इत्यादि हमारे सामतंत्र इत्यादि है पुष्पसूत्र इत्यादि उसमें समूचा विवरण दिया हुआ है अब देखिए अग्न आया ही वीतये गृणानो हव्यदातये निहोता सत्से बरिहिषी ये ऋचा पाठ है इसका पद पाठ होता है अग्ने आया ही वीतये गृणानः हव्यदातये हव्यदातये निहोता सत्से बरिहिषी ये पद पाठ है इसका गान ओग्नाये आयाहि बोइतो के बाद जो गान है अग्ना आया ही भी तयाई, दोनों में अंतर कितना है इसको दिखा रहे हैं, लेकिन ऋचा वही है, इसीलिए गान संख्या बहुत अधिक हो जाता है। ऋचा संख्या 1875 है, लेकिन गान संख्या हमारे सामवेद में 3700 कुछ है। ये जो अधिक होने का कारण, कहीं कहीं एक ऋचा का पुनानस्सो मधारया आपो वसानो अर्षसि आरत्न धायो निमृतस्य सीदसि उत्सो देवो हिरण्ययः, ये ऋचा का 15 गान है। परितोषिंचताश्रुतम, इस एक ही ऋचा का 16 गान है। इसी प्रकार 8 गान, 9 गान, 3 गान, 4 गान, 5 गान बहुत से हैं, जिसके चलते ये अच्छा सब गान का नामकरण भी अलग है, और वो नामकरण अलग होने के नाते उसका ऋषि भी अलग है, उसका विनियोग भी अलग होता है। आप प्रश्न कर सकते हैं जो उस ऋचा से विनियोग, यहाँ पर कोई एक अनुष्ठान में विनियोग कर रहे हैं कुछ, और फिर वही ऋचा से और जगह दूसरा जगह कोई एक विनियोग कर रहे हैं, तो ये दोनों विनियोग तो एक ही ऋचा से हो रहा है आप कहेंगे, लेकिन हमारे ब्राह्मण ग्रंथ जो है, हमारे अष्ट ब्राह्मण, हमारे सामवेद में अष्ट ब्राह्मण होता है। अष्ट ब्राह्मण में तांड्य महाब्राह्मण सबसे बृहत है, उसके बाद षड्विंश ब्राह्मण होता है, सामविधान ब्राह्मण, आर्षीय ब्राह्मण इत्यादि बहुत से ब्राह्मण हैं, 8 ब्राह्मण हैं। तो वो ब्राह्मण ग्रंथ में इसका बारे में बहुत बढ़िया से उल्लेख किया है। तो देवता के बारे में देवताध्याय ब्राह्मण कहा गया है। विनियोग के लिए हमारे तांड्य और षड्विंश ब्राह्मण जो है, ये श्रुत प्रयोग में जितना विनियोग होता है इसके बारे में कहते हैं। मंत्र ब्राह्मण एक है, छांदोग्य मंत्र ब्राह्मण है, इसमें कहते हैं जो स्मार्त कर्म इत्यादि हम लोग को जात कर्म से लेकर अंत्येष्टि तक का जितना विधान है, जितना बताया गया मंत्र बताया गया, उसके बारे में विधान दिया हुआ है, मंत्र दिया हुआ है। कुछ कुछ ऐसा मंत्र है जो सामवेद में आपके गायन नहीं किया जा सकता है, और कुछ कुछ मंत्र ऐसा है जो ब्राह्मण वाक्य को गायन स्वरूप किया जाता है। उसके लिए प्राचीन काल में जब हम लोग जबकि सभ्यता का आगमन हो रहा था, उस समय हम सब ने ये किए थे, मैंने श्रुत कर्म करते थे। सर्वप्रथम अग्नि देवता का ही पूजन होता था, अग्नि को ही देवता स्वरूप मान लेते थे लोग। तो अग्नि को आधारित करके वहाँ के जो निवासी हैं, ऋतिक लोग तो अपना यज्ञ करते हैं, लेकिन वहाँ के निवासी लोग जो हैं वो तो शायद उसमें ब्राह्मण भी है, क्षुद्र भी है, अन्य जाति के भी हैं, वो लोग मंत्र न सुने, इसके लिए एक विधान निकाला है अकार और भकार, इससे रतंत्र साम है। आभित्वा सूरनो नोमो वा आदुग्धा इव धेनव ईशानमस्य जगतः सुवाद्रेशाम् आईशा नामा इन्द्राः तास्थूषा ऐसा मूल ऋचा का गान है। अवित्वा सूरनो नमो अदुग्धाय वधे नवः ईशानमस्य जगतस, इस प्रकार है। अभी उसका ही जो इस मंत्र गुप्त है, मंत्र जो है ये गोपनीय है, ये अन्य प्रजाति लोग न सुने, इसके लिए भकार से गान करते हैं। ओम बाग भू भा भी बभे भब भी भा भ भ भ भ सुभाद्रेशाम, इस प्रकार वहाँ पर होता है। उसी प्रकार गायत्री मंत्र का भी होता है। हाँ, ओम जैसा तत्सवितुर्वरेण्योम भार्गो देवस्य धीमाहि धियो यो न प्रचोहिम आदायो ये मूल गायत्री है इसका। तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यम आप सब जानते हैं, उसी का ही गान इस प्रकार होता है। लेकिन ये मंत्र सब जगह प्रचारित नहीं करना है, क्योंकि शास्त्र में विधान है, इसीलिए उसको तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यम ओम ओम ओ ओ ओ ओ ओ ओ ओ
So that is how they bring out, there is this akshara is there is the swara is there, the udatta, anudatta, swarita is there, the measurement, guru, laghu, they are also there. He goes even beyond pluta and, it carries it. And when they recite it, Agna, you come, oh Agni, Lord Agni, come here. The invocation, that is the bhava. So when they sing it, and they will see with all the bhavas to get that God in that fire so that they can offer it. So it is the origin of how they use the mantras, the patas, and also the gana. Now, there are some sages who went to Bharata and asked him, all right, now you call it Veda, Natya Veda, but who is to authenticate that this is correct, this is not correct, and what is its authenticity? Then Bharata gives a lot of details, and we also have an important verse which says that like Veda, then mantra and patha, chitra and vaditra, all these have the same authority as that of the Veda. Veda, mantra, you just next one, you see. Then, in Bharata's Natyashastra, we come across this word, prayogam uddhatam smritva, when Shiva thought of his sandhya tandava, prayogam uddhatam smritva, so prayuktam tatho haraha, tanduna, so ganagranya, bharataya vyadi drishata. He taught this to Bharata through Tandu, his foremost gana. This is Tandava, Sandhya Tandava. This is what is mentioned in Bharata's Natyashastra, fourth chapter, this is the karanas, angaharas, sthanas, and so on. Now, the same thing, we have Devi Parvati teaching it to Ushas, the daughter of Bana, which is called Lasya. Lasyam asya jagataha pritya parvatya samadhi drisate. Yes, buddhva tandavam samboho matyebhya munayava vadan. Parvati to anusastisma lasyam bhanatmajam usham. The daughter of Bana, Bhanatmajam Usham, she taught that. That is called Lasya. This is an interesting verse which is found in Sangeet Ratnakara of Sarangadeva, who gives how Natya came and it got spread. That Parvati taught it to Usha, and Usha taught that to Dwaravati Gopyaha. To the gopis of Dwaravati, Dwaraka, Usha taught this Lasya. Then, Tabihi Saurashtra Yoshitaha. Then, these Dwaravati gopis taught the Lasya to Saurashtra Naris. And they, Tabihi to Sikshita Naryaha Nana Jana. So now here is a tradition where Bharata's Natya Shastra moves in Saurashtra Desa, where the Saurashtras would like to say that we got it first from the Gopi. So this has been transmitted by the Saurashtra Naris and then it became Nasya. It only shows that every region had its own love and affection and the style of performance. And so we have a tradition in Tamil Nadu, which is mentioned in Silapadikaram and the commentary, that sage Agastya was responsible for bringing both music and dance to earth. Of course, originally, at the beginning, Agastya is said to come from northern part of India, via Vatapi, bringing 18 families of rulers and 18 families of Velir chieftains. He brought them down and he went to Padiyamalai near Kanyakumari district, which is supposed to be the abode of sage Agastya. Now, this is the legendary aspect, but we have a historical aspect also. We have a number of copper plate grants, sasanas, given by the Pandya rulers, which says that Agastya taught them both Tamil and Sanskrit. Both Tamil and Sanskrit, he crowned them as the rulers of the Mathura country. Mathura is the southern Mathura, like the northern Mathura. This is southern Mathura, which we now call Madurai. And then, according to their own sasana, Pandyas, 8th century sasanas, they say he did the performance of Abhishega, Pattabhishega, according to Atharva Veda. And then he was responsible for this Sangam, establishment of Sangha. And so we have a tradition of this Ilakkanam, Tolgapiyam, which is the earliest grammar which has survived, that was taught to Tolgapiyar by Agastya, according to one tradition. And then this tradition is reflected in the commentary, medieval commentators of 10th century and 12th century. They say that the division in Tamil of dance into Aham and Puram was classified by Agastya. It, Agastya, this has been done by Agastya, they say. And then there is a chapter on what we call Sayul. Sayul is almost Samskrita or Chandas. There's a separate chapter in Bharatanatya Shastra on Chanda. And there they say that these were given to us by Agastya. Then in Purana, Purathinai, there is a chapter called Purathinai in Tamil Ilakkanam, grammar, where number of dance forms are mentioned. You know, Aham is Sringara. Purathinai means all Purathinai or external one, Dharma and Artha. Kama is Sringara, and they don't speak of moksha because you get the moksha when you follow the Dharma, Artha and Kama. So there also, they say, some of these dance forms, Agastya taught to those who were of low class for their own forms of dance. Ahatyan, Irigulatore, Adavaitanan, Ahatyan Dane is the sutra. So number of sutras of Agastya on poetry, music and dance are incorporated in the commentaries of 10th and 12th century. And then in the Silapadigaram itself, we know, there is the story that Agastya was received by Indra. When he conquered Vritra, he wanted to give a big feast to Agastya, sage Agastya. Agastya came there. And Indra wanted Urvasi to dance. And Urvasi, you know, they used to take the screen first, and she entered. And when the screen was removed, she saw Jayanta, the son of Indra, was seated in front. So he was so beautiful. She, for a moment, you know, she fell in love with him. And he also looked at Urvasi. And this, the mischief maker Narada, sage Narada, who was sitting down, he saw that. So he actually played the veena in a wrong way. So Urvasi lost her step. Agastya got angry. He was a master of dance. And to invite such a great guest and dance a wrong step, so he said, you go and be born in the earth. No, so he was. She was cursed to go in there. And Jayanta was also asked to go to the earth. And he looked at Narada, you are the fellow who played all the mystic, so let your veena go to the earth. This is only to say that it is a legendary way of telling that Agastya has given the dance to the earth, to the southern part, that is the Tamil country. So here, there it is the Saurashtra, here it is the Tamil Agastya, who is the author. And the medieval commentator Adiyarkanallar, he says, there were two texts before Tulkarpiyam. One was Bharatam, another one was called Agastyam. Both the texts were in Tamil. But by the time of Tulkarpiyam, these two texts have disappeared. And so whatever was available, they did with that. So we have one on Saurashtra, one here. And friends, when Bharata mentions in the Natya Avatara number of people, we have references to women from Kerala. Then we have what you call Kedara Desa, and Malavas, Magadas. These are all some of the people who specialize in music and dance who are mentioned in Bharata's Natya Shastra, which means that these are all the different areas where different styles have developed, and these have been absorbed by them. Now, luckily for Tamil country, we are able to document from around the second century AD onwards, down to earth, a continuous story of development. Now it is for us to see how in each region, This regional dance, which we call Odissi, and we call Goundali, and so many things, developed there. What are the literature? And this is one thing which shows that there was a special school of music and dance in Tamil Nadu, developed by sage Agastya, following Bharata. For all of them, they go back to Bharata. That is the most interesting point. We get next one, please. You see Parvati, last, she teaches Raja, Ushasya, Dwaravati, Gopis, Saurashtra, Naris, and so on. Next. Now, this is the most important point. You have two schools. One is Margi, and another is Desi. Margi and Desi are what are called Iruvahai Kutu in Chalapadigara. Margi, according to, they will tell you, that which was sung and codified and given by Bharata in front of Sambhu, and that is followed, is called Margi. That's what we call also Vadhu. Then Desi, that those which are there in each region, sung and to their liking, using their own language also, that is called Desi. So Tamil dance, what they call Tamil dance, in Iruvahai Kutu, Aryam and Tamil. Aryam is Bharata, and what you call Tamil is Desi Kutu. This is mentioned in Silapathikaram. So actually you have 2000 years old of this division of Bharata tradition and the local tradition. Next one. You see, yo margitaha, doesn't matter, Sanskrit, good Sanskrit, good language, you just listen for a few seconds. I think it is necessary. Yo margitaha virinchyadehi prayuktaha bharatadibihi, those that which were used by Bharata and Virinchi are there. Devasya purataha samboho, samboho purataha devasya. Niyatam abhyudaya prataha, they give prosperity to those who are. But that is Margi. Dese dese jananam, in every region, the public, yati ruchya, ruchina romba pudikirudhe, that region like this particular dance. So this is ruchi. Whichever region, out of its own love and affection and taste, hridaya ranjakam, that which pleases their heart, geetam cha, vadanam cha, both music and instrumental music, tat desi iti gurita, that is called. So now, it is very unfortunate that people who know nothing about Sanskrit or nothing about Tamil tradition, say if Sanskrit comes, Tamil will be swallowed. Here is a special example which says that Margi is, for those who are interested in that classical tradition, every region should use their own sound, music, and dance form, and they encouraged it. So the Sanskrit tradition never stood against any regional language, but on the other hand, it only encouraged the regional language to have its own music, own dance, and never in the history, from its beginning to end, that we have any conflict and Sanskrit standing in the way. Now, this is a wonderful poem, but I don't think I have time to read this, interpret it. This is in Sangeet Ratnakara of Sarangadeva. What a beautiful thinkers they have been. You see, इसे ब्रह्म ग्रंथि च मारुतानु गतिना चित्तेन हृत् पंकजे. व्हाट अ ब्यूटीफुल पोएट्री. इट रेफर्स टू इन द एंड ही से वंदे नादतनुम. I salute the form, the mere embodiment of music, not the God. Of course, we say God. So you can interpret it as God and also as Nadatanu. We have Nadatanumanism. See, Surinam Anuranjakaha Srutipadam Yogyam Swayam Rajate Yatmat Grama Vibhaga. Here, Grama is the music grama. Vibhaga is the division into grama. Varna rachana, varnas. Alankara and jati. All these are all the words we use in our musical tradition. Yes, mouth, vande, nadatanum. I salute that. Because for writing the whole Sangeetha Ratnakara, he puts it as the first word. Wonderful, wonderful Sanskrit poem. Personification, we say abstraction of the whole music. Well, that requires a different class. Now, here I want to show that we have this, see, Sadashiva ta to Shiva. Shiva means Parvati. Then Brahma. Then Bharata. And then Kashyapu Muniki. I am just trying to say that there is mythical or legendary part up to Sadashiva, Shiva, Brahma. But when you come down to the real earth as a human being, Bharata is the first person who is mentioned. And all of them, they take from Bharata. This is because of the next one. So we have in this Sangeetha Ratnakara, 35 mythical and human poets are called Purva Acharyas. We are now remembering the modern Acharyas that is required, but 2000 years ago who have formulated and who have kept us alive, all this should also be remembered, and they are called Purva Acharyas. Smarana. Next one, please. Matanga, Kohala, Dattila are well known names. Next. Ramba. Remember, Urvasi represented dance and Ramba represents music. So that's a very interesting information he gives. Arjuna was a great musician, master. Then Pandava. Anjaneya. Anjaneya Matam, there is a music called Hanumat Matam, music treatise on Anjaneya. And that is mentioned in this text. And then Nandikeshwara. There is so much, but I have to cut down. I must maintain the thala, otherwise it will become apatal, you know. Next one. Ravana and Nandikeshwara. They are all masters of music. Next. Swati. Swati is mentioned in Salapatigaram. Next. Rudrata, Someshwara, Jagateka Malla, Bhojaraja. These are all musicians, the great masters of music. Next. Then we have this one, Natya Shastra. Commentators, Vyakhyataraha. Commentators on Bharata's Natya Shastra. So friends, Bharata's Natya Shastra is not confined to Natya. It engulfs the whole of music. In fact, even all the music, modern musical traditions are derived from Bharata's texts. So musicians must pay as much attention to Bharata's text in music than Natya. Next. These are the people who have commented on Bharata's Natya Shastra before Sarangadeva. Next. Now, but the first one, it is seen Bharata's name appears immediately after Brahma. So he is the foremost primordial teacher of both classical music and dance. And his text is extraordinary text. It's not one for small dance alone. So it's Vyakhyataraha. भट्ट अभिनवगुप्तश्च ही मेंशन्स आल्सो अभिनवगुप्ता एज़ द कमेंटेटर एंड देन श्रीमद् कीर्तिधर ही मेंशन्स आल्सो कीर्तिधर अन्य देन ही सेज देयर आर सो मेनी अदर पीपल दोज़ हू हैव डन सो मच एंड लेफ्ट सो मच दैट इट इज समथिंग लाइक अ बिग ओशन आई एम ट्राइंग टू टेक देम आउट एंड ट्राई टू गिव इट इन माई ओन वर्ड्स दैट्स व्हाट ही सेज सो दिस teachers next I think that is the one and you can leave it like that because I don't have the other one just a few points required and then I am finished sir now we need some discussion for it no? One minute Yes. You know, in Bharata's Natya Shastra, we get a list. That is, the first Atreya is one of the Muni, who is mentioned as a great master of music and dance. Vasishta, Pulastya, Angirasa, Gautama, Agastya. And others. I am not listing. There are quite large number of other rishis. It's not necessary to go. Now, Agastya is also mentioned as a contemporary of Bharata. Now, friends, these names, Agastya, Gautama, etc., should not be taken as the rishis, Vedic rishis exactly, but they were their descendants, the Gotra name, because Gautama will be the Gautama Gotra, Agastya will be a Agastya Gotra, like that. Anyway, that Agastya was a contemporary of Bharata, and he was among those rishis who questioned what is the authenticity of these texts. How do you justify it? How do you call it Veda? If there is a dispute whether this is the correct Lakshana, this is the correct Lakshana, which is the correct one, who will tell us? So this was the question put by all these questions by these rishis. And you see that Bharata's Natya Shastra is a down-to-earth text. It's not a fictitious text. It questions. It's a scientific text. At every step, it is a scientific text. And so, we now know that Agastya was the head of, or the originator of, Tamil music and dance. And he derives it from, he has learnt it directly from Bharata. And well, there are many other points which we can discuss. I was to confine myself to only the origin, but there is so much. There are so many masters who have written. And it is a fascinating story, not only to listen to music, but also to study how they developed it through the centuries and how it has been observed. I tell you only one instance and close my talk. In Silapadikaram, we have Arangetru Kadai. Generally, in Arangetru Kadai, Madhavi's dance is described. And it is in an order. It comes from Agastya. It comes from Urvasi and Jayanta coming down to earth. And because when they were here, the girl who was born here was called Madhavi. This Madhavi was born in that family. Spotless family, they say. They have brought dance to earth. And then she must be Adalum, Padalum, Ayahum, மூன்றில் ஒன்று குறைபடாமல் ஒன்றி நிறுத்த கீத விசக்ஷணா இன் நாட்டிய சாஸ்திர எக்ஸாக்ட் டிரான்ஸ்லேஷன் ஆஃப் திஸ் அண்ட் தென் இட் ஸ்பீக்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஃபைவ் அட் தி ஏஜ் ஆஃப் ஃபைவ் ஷீ ஸ்டார்டட் லேர்னிங் கம்ப்ளீட் இட் இஸ் அ விரத திஸ் இட் இஸ் அ விரத தட் வவ் தட் வி வில் டூ ஒன்லி திஸ் ஒர்க் அண்ட் வி நோ தட் ஃப்ரம் அவர் excellent dancers now. Those who have dedicated themselves, they shine as the topmost dancers of this country. But I've casually, Saturday, Sunday, 1 hour, the teacher goes away, a girl goes away, and this type of dance can only be till up to Arangetram, and afterwards we'll forget them. That is not thing. Lifelong dedication is required. Sada pragalbhacha. Like that. So, that chapter is a complete sangraha of Natya Shastra. It is a Natya Shastra sangraha. The poet's qualification, the singer's qualification, the musician's vadya qualification, yai, vinay, and flute, and mridanga, and then construction of your theater. What has construction of theater to do with the Chalapadigaram story? Nothing. But the poet wants to show that these are all there as a part of the whole. And so we have the influence of Bharata's Natyashastra completely transformed into Tamil. And now if I say it is from Bharata, people quite rightly, they are so emotional because it has come down for 2,000 years. Why not? I question it. So they say it's not from Bharata. But a discerning scholar will study it, represent it. And regional school needs to be studied. We have so much work yet to be done. There are enough material in Tamil and Sanskrit. And we have great scholars, intelligent scholars, and wonderful dancers. And I hope it will progress well. Thank you very much for your any. Yes, sir. Your observation. Now,
I know Dr. Nagaswamy for almost 34 years. And I know Natya Shastra for about 45 years. What he says is absolutely essential for us all to understand. Because, you know, Bharata begins Natya Shastra with a wonderful sloka, Pranamya Shirasa Devo, Pitamaha Maheshwarau Natya Shastram Parvakshyami Brahmanaya Dudahuratam. It is a very unusual sloka. The very beginning of the Natya Shastra is a very unusual sloka because it begins with salutation to two male gods. Pranamya Sirasa Devo Pitamaha Maheshwara. Pitamaha is Brahma, Maheshwara is Shiva. Because he learned dance from these two people. Pitamaha Maheshwara Natya Shastram Parvakshyami Brahmanaya Dudahratam, what is given to me by Brahma. And Dr. Nagaswamy said the Deshi. And very peculiarly, Bharata says in Natya Shastra, in the sixth chapter, not in the first chapter, anybody who talks about, you know, any text normally says, in the very beginning of the book, this is what I am going to deal with in this book. Bharata does not choose first chapter, second chapter, third chapter, fourth or fifth. He goes up to the sixth chapter and then says, in this book I am going to deal with these 11 things. He says, rasa, 11 things, you can count your fingers. Sanskrit is not a difficult language. All of us know this language. We don't want to understand that we know this language. It's very easy, simple language. Rasa, bhava, abhinaya, dharmi, vritti, pravrittaya, siddhi, swara, tadatodhyam, ganam, ranganja, sarvashah, sangrahaha. This is what he says. These are the 11 points. And the most wonderful thing is, Pravruttayaha means regional variations. And he mentions four regional variations. Avanti, Panchala Madhyama, Odra Maghadi, Dakshinatya. And please don't try to classify this on the present general, you know, Indian map and states of Karnataka. These are all born yesterday, day before yesterday. So he classifies And this Bharata is not confined, mind you, to India alone. From Afghanistan to Indonesia to Jakarta to Angkor Wat to, you know, all these places, you find Bharata's Natya Shastra. In fact, Dr. Padma Subramanian brings one idol from Thailand and says it is Bharata's statue. That apart, what I would like to tell, I have no questions to ask to Dr. Nagaswamy because he has given all those things that is necessary to be understood as origin of music and dance. And Bharata's Natya Shastra has 36 chapters, 6,000 verses. And the 36 chapters begin with, these are the 11 topics he covered. Ranga stage construction is the second chapter. Natya Utpatti is the first chapter. Ranga Devata Pujana is the third chapter. Tandava is the fourth chapter. Purva Ranga Vidhanam is fifth chapter, Rasa is seventh chapter, Bhava is seventh chapter. You can go on and talk about all the 36 chapters. What is important is that six chapters deal with music alone. In those days, until almost Sangeeta Ratnakara and even later on until 17th century, all treatises which dealt with dance invariably dealt with music. And vice versa. If it is a music book, there are dance chapters. If it is a dance book, there are music chapters. Because Gitam Vajyancha Nruchyancha Trayam Sangeetam Uchyate. And literature is such an important aspect. Vachika Abhinaya has about 11 chapters in Bharata's Natya Shastra is Vachika Abhinaya. If you take music chapters also into Vachika Abhinaya, you get 14, 15, 16, 17. Dealing with Vachikabhinaya, and then again from 27 to 32. All chapters deal with Sangeetam and Vachikam, because as he said in the Shikshavalli of Taittiriya Upanishad, Shiksha Vyakhyasyamaha, the very development of language, the origin of the language, and the Dattila, the Kohala and others, all these are mentioned as sons of Bharata. Bharata, you know, when Brahma gave to Bharata, Brahma told him to teach it to his children. And he is supposed to have 100 sons like we have Dhritarashtra. He is not Dhritarashtra, that is the only difference. And when you see the 100 list, you find 105 sons. He says Shataputra, and then you find Shata and plus 5. Because 100 does not necessarily mean 100. You see, for example, you tell your son or your wife or your husband, and one glass thanni eduthu vaango, you ask him two or three times, he doesn't bring. You say 100 times solla enna kekkave maatana. Did you tell him 100 times? So 100 does not necessarily mean 100. And the most wonderful thing again is he mentioned Swati, the saint. Swati is the originator of percussion instruments. Beautifully written in Natya Shastra, one day when Swati was going to take bath in a river, it just rained. And he went to a pond, and there is a drop of water falling from a branch of a tree onto a lotus leaf at a regular interval. He thought, why not something like that is created to understand Thala and rhythm? And that is the origin of percussion instruments. And I have not found in any language, I know some languages, I don't need to tell how many languages I know, but I have seen world literature and found that there is no book equivalent to Natya Shastra. No book on the earth is equivalent to Natya Shastra, particularly dealing with the science of dramaturgy, Natya Shastra. Another very important thing is Bharata does not use the word Nritya, he uses Natya. Natya means drama, please don't understand Natya means dance. And Nritya he uses. There is no word Nritya in the entire Natya Shastra. And the Swati origin of this, and the most wonderful thing, at the time of Bharata, at the 2200 years ago, how many musical instruments would have been there? 10, 15, 11, 12, 13, below 20 definitely. And today, hundreds of thousands of instruments. Everywhere you find instruments. You find a part, you make a hole on the part and that becomes another instrument. You have different kinds of instruments today. And Bharata classifies instruments 2,300 years ago into four. Tata, Avanadha, Dhana and Sushiraya. All stringed instruments, all percussion instruments, all solid instruments, all wind instruments. Is there a fifth classification today? No. Impossible. That is the scientific nature of our rishis. And he has been repeatedly telling Dr. Nagaswami that the questions were asked by saints, sages to Bharata. What have sages to do with Nati Shastra? Why he should be taught? You know, the list of 44 sages are given, Angirasa, Varasa, Bharadvaja, Kashyapa. You talk about, you know, if you want to add one more, you can add. There is nothing to add, actually. There are so many, 44 of them, that all of us know. Any name that you take of a rishi is there in that. Bharata taught this Natyashastra to those 44 rishis. Why Natyashastra to rishis? Because, very beautifully said, origin of music and dance. Jagraha Patyam Rugvedat Samabhyo Gitamevacha Yajurvedat Abhinayan Rasan Atharvanadapi. He has taken four components from four Vedas. Jagraha Patyam Rugvedat. From Rugvedam he took Patyam. Samabhyo Gitamevacha. See, Sanskrit is such a beautiful, simple language. You understand automatically. Sama, Gita, rendu words ketale, Samathilinda Gita Mangirka, Tiryade. அவ்வளவுதான் சான்ஸ்கிரிட். யஜுர்வேதாத் அபிநயான் ரசான் அதர்வணாதபி. இந்த நாலு வேதத்திலிருந்து நாலு எடுத்துக்கிட்டு பஞ்சம வேதமாக நாட்டியவேதம் பண்ணியிருக்கார். வென் இட் இஸ் வேதா, வை நாட் ரிஷீஸ்? ரிஷீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் வேதிக் பீப்புள். ஸோ தட் இஸ் வை இட் வாஸ் டாட் டு தி வேதிக் ஸ்காலர்ஸ் அண்ட் தே ஹவ் ஆஸ்க்டு க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் எவ்ரிவேர் தே ஆஸ்க் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ். And like Arjuna asked questions in Bhagavad Gita to Sri Krishna for clearing our doubts, the rishis have asked questions to Bharata to clear our doubts. And we have a Nagaswami who has come in the form of Bharata today to talk to us about this wonderful topic, origin of Indian music and dance. Thank you very much.
Maybe 10 minutes for, 10 minutes for question answer. Madam, come and say a few things. Come, no problem.
I am, believe it or not, I am not fit to be speaking in the company of these great luminaries, these sages actually, modern day sages. What I don't even want to say anything except that I consider him my guru in many ways. And we are blessed to have people like this to give us these insights. Where would we go? What would we artists do? What would people do without this wealth of knowledge? And we can taste a little bit from them. And that is what happens every time I listen to him. I don't want to say anything except to say I'm blessed to be born at a time to listen to Dr. Nagaswami or Papuji. And also one point alone I want to say, he made that point and I felt like saying here. You know, these days, musicians, dancers, we're all gone apart. Though we say we have music for dance, musicians, dance, adhyanna, oru alachyam. And we are really gone apart in many ways. And actually, without neenga sonnele, dance cannot exist without wonderful music, because dance is music. And if we and literature neenga sonnele, how many young people these days immerse themselves? There are many young people here, and there's Shruti Sagar sitting at the back, who's a wonderful musician. But I really feel that all young people should not lose touch with these three coming together, because that is what, for me as a dancer, listening to this reiterates all that I believe. Thank you so much for enriching our lives and our understanding of the arts. Thank you so much.
Any other questions from the audience, please? Doctor is available for you another 5 minutes.
There are two occasions when people don't ask questions.
When they understand. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much for giving us. And I must thank both Mr. Venugopal Rao and Mr. Ramakrishnan for giving this opportunity and such a lovely audience. And it is difficult to get Srota. Srota is very difficult. It is very difficult to get good audience, and the audience inspires us to more of what we know about it. And I'm so thankful to Mr. Ramakrishnan, and I hope we have more some sort of this intellectual activity also.